Greetings, hello, and welcome back to some more Crusader Kings 3 as Island. We just finished off some minor wars here in the last episode, and I was looking around a little bit to see what our next steps are. And I noticed one little detail in regards to my prestige, that I'm on the cusp of getting the next major level here, Exalted Amongst Men, which allows me to declare war for kingdom title. So I could actually, once our truces are, attack Alba for the kingdom of Alba directly, get all his land, well, if we defeat him, and be a happy little camper at that point, which would probably then also immediately allow me to form the empire. So that we're really close. I think you just need, we're still gonna need the 2000 prestige to actually declare the war, if I'm not mistaken. So we gotta see how we get there, but I think that probably is gonna be the next approach. Problem is just, he has a an alliance to the King of Galicia, which is down here, and they are currently in a war together for the Kingdom of Asturias. So, and they had 99% war score, and also my uncle is in that war. So that war is going to be over in a second, and then Galicia is going to be much stronger, and that could prove to be a problem. Then again, we currently still have a truce with him anyway for 2 years, so we need to wait a little bit either way. So let's just, I'm gonna unpause, go for speed 4 for now. Just want to see what this war, how that shakes out. We're gonna go on a hunt, even though we don't have any strength to burn. So I was looking around any potential abductions or murder schemes, and I didn't find anything. I don't just want to murder someone just for the sake of murdering someone, right? So yeah, we're wasting the stress relief here, but a hunt is always a good chance to get some more prestige. One other thing I quickly wanted to mention, because I know there are lots of helpful comments always in the videos of what I could do, and I just want to say that I'm not ignoring some of that stuff, but there's also a lot of things that the game allows you to do in terms of the game mechanics, but I always feel like a little bit, if I'm role-playing, so to say, as that character, I don't want to do that. Like, you know how we had all the issues with the inheritance and then going for this elective system and trying to find the right person? Yes, you could also just stay on the partition election and then just go to every heir of yours that you don't like and just go, yeah, I'm gonna disinherit you. That also has some other impacts on your dynasty score and your renown, but that's kind of the easy way out. But yeah, I'm not always interested in the most easy way. Anyway, the White Wolf. I'm riding ahead of the group as the hills suddenly grow still around me. The silence is almost palpable, and I struggle to hear even the noise of the horse's hooves. Just as I'm about to turn back to find the others, I glimpse it ahead of me, blurry as in a dream, a wolf as white as snow. Like something from a tale, I must have it. Or I could just say, I must have it, or it's just a wolf, we'll hunt others, giving me some stewardship. But no, it's the white wolf. Follow the white wolf into the hills. An almost unnatural silence hangs heavy over us, and the sudden sound of a voice startles me. My lord, there you are. I turn around to see the rest of my party, having caught up to me. As I look back, the wolf is gone. I could either say, yeah, I'm gonna get that white wolf, or I just said, yeah, I scouted ahead. No, I will get that wolf. And we're returning, reinvigorated, 150 prestige. Thank you very much. So this war's over. Galicia is a little bit stronger. And for some, like, I'm not sure. I saw that my uncle here, the King of Wales, was in that war down there. But now he's no longer allied to him. Like, why were you fighting in that war then? Fool. Why is that like a somehow family related? I don't know. Okay, we can seclude ourselves here. Yeah. So we got now the next level of prestige also, which is great. That should also mean we get more income and troops from our followers, because we're tribal, that depends on the prestige level. Yeah, we also want to give our levies a little bit time to recover. What's this? My dear cousin, my marriage to Lady Senna is clearly not blessed by God. She's a drunkard. Okay. Will you grant me a divorce? Why are you like... Sure. Am I somehow... Like, there's no head of faith. Like, why is he asking me? I guess he needs to ask his liege. Yeah, sure. Enjoy. What are our council guys doing anyway? You're improving relations. I think we need to still convert a little bit. I probably want to have the Viking faith out of here. You are still improving development. We're development 7 now. Actually, we kind of good on that. Could try to convert more into Irish culture, or we just say, hey, give me more taxes. How far are you? Yeah, he barely did anything. All right, collect taxes instead. That's fine. You're improving our vassals, that's great. You're discovering hostile schemes, that's also good. Alright, carry on. East Anglia is attacking over here. And now they're stopping to attack. Yeah, speed 5. I think it's like October of 58 where the Truce of Alba runs out. And Longhouse Contractor, that's nice. What was Longhouse again? Faction disbanded. King Gundbald of East Francia. Holy crap. Has lost against Coronatal Sign in the Liberty War. Well, well, well. That's King Gundbald. So now we have... What just happened here? Okay. King Deadbird. Great Moravia? What? Excuse me. Okay, so is West Frontier kind of broke up, right? We've got Lothringia, we've got Aquitaine. I'm not even sure who Count Winter is. Like, for some reason he was the war leader, but he's now just some dude in East Frontier. Which also kind of broke apart here into East Frontier, Bavaria, Great Moravia. Things are happening. That being said, Mr. Aquitaine has like 1300 troops and no alliances, and he owns Cornwall. Hmm. Your question is, Mr. Aquitaine, who's your current heir? Princess Sibylle. And the nice thing about an empire breaking apart like this is there's suddenly a lot more people you could marry for alliances, but also, you know, Cornwall. So hypothetically speaking, if I were to declare war here for the conquest of Cornwall, because my 75 prestige is vastly inferior. Like this is going to be a thorn in my side otherwise. Yeah, let's just declare this war. Give me my ready point. And raise everything. Probably want to go down from speed 4, 5 even. Alright, split you in half. You move there, you're gonna sit there. Now, I'm just gonna assume that he's gonna raise his troops somewhere down here and then come over with a ship. You know, actually, let's have you sit over there. That way I can ship out to here and come to island proper if he attacks there. Anglo-Saxon insular populists targeting me. Okay. And there are Anglo-Saxon Azatru populists. Okay. Sure game. Make up your mind. Do we want to invite champions? That's also gonna cost us prestige. Champions are kind of important. Let's hold off on it for now. Passing suspicion. It's a well-known fact that coaches will scheme and plot, but I may be able to use this to my advantage. If I can keep my coaches suspicious of each other, yada yada yada. Can spread rumors with a 69% chance, nice, of gaining some XP. Or I can just get more scheme resistance. Problem is, we have a 30% chance of losing prestige. But, you know, lifestyle XP. Cool. Let's click that away. Actually, go to split 4. Keeping an eye out on enemy troops. I don't see anything right now. It's also paused. That's why the siege is not progressing. Who? What are you doing? For the Kingdom of England. You have 500 troops. Are you crazy? Alright. Pause. Is he serious? Okay, he's allied to the King of Wales. I'm not sure if he's allied to Alba. Well, can I call you into my conquest? Now, if he's fighting alongside me against Aquitaine, I don't think he can suddenly fight against me in the war for England. I'm just gonna call everybody else into the war against England. Against this. He just declared war on me and I... No, okay. That would have been weird. But I can... No. Cannot. Call him to war. Again. Give me a button with call everybody into all my wars. It's not costing me anything. Something like that. I might actually just move on him here. Troopshires under siege. Like 500 troops. To the obnoxious king, High King Arm. If you burn with your precious armor for too long, we're done paying your taxes. Who are you? Peasant revolt. They're 100% discontent. Peasants in Ireland, mostly. In Connacht, Dermot, Desmond, well, yeah, and all the land that I control. So I could give them lose 75 control. And increased autonomy, that sounds not good. Spawn an army. I don't think I can just leave that at the side and get my army over there in position. Ah, you know, I think I have enough allied troops here. So I can kind of do that. It's not okay. It's not a lot. They're kind of they're all going out to sea and coming over here. That's weird. But they're sieging my capital. Okay. Burying the hatchet. King Roland, we have had our differences in the past. My sister. And she's my I thought I didn't want her as my rival. Didn't I at every turn not take actions to make her my rival? Yes. No, I don't want her. I missed something. My lord, the search of yours for mere beast. I have to admit, it worries me. My archbishop approaches me as I sift through the reports of new sightings of the White Wolf. Evidently anything that demands so much attention could be sent by Saturn, if its existence is not a sign of the Lord himself. I could say the wolf is a messenger of God, either giving me some piety or... is that piety or is that devotion? Piety. Why is that not blue then? Or upsetting him? Could just upset him anyway, or could stop doing that. No, no, no. The wolf is a messenger. You don't understand. My brother has been taken prisoner. That's unfortunate for him. Oh, he's gathering his troops over there. We're still outnumbering them, and we're gonna be the defender in the hills because it's our castle. So I think we should be good. Education decision for my daughter. I was shocked when I caught her trying to steal from Tavrochest of visiting Duke Mail Ainfate. She confessed she had thought she could get away with it, but now knows it was wrong. So she's currently honest. I could make her deceitful, or I could make her humble. No, being honest is great. What are you training to be? Intrigue. Honesty. Intrigue. Yeah, it's gonna be great for you. No, I think I should totally get you to be deceitful if I want to have someone with high intrigue. I'm not sure what good it's gonna do for me, as she's just my daughter, but you know what? You have to cover up your wrongdoing. A little stress never hurt anyone much for long. Right. Last perk. Schema. Okay, the treat schema. I'm now a plus 5 intrigue schema. Very nice. Who do they have as an army commander that I get a negative penalty here? 23 Marshal, Lord Utgal, rough terrain expert. Maybe. Let's see. So he doesn't have that much commander advantage, but he's a rough terrain expert. Well, currently I have a guy with 15, or I could get a guy with 11 who gains plus 4 in hilts. Feel like it's going to be the same outcome. Get the rolls, peasants, whatever. The enemies. Alright. 100%. Get out of here. Peasant rebel destroyed. Imprison enemy leader here. Yeah. Alright. What can I do with you? You just have seven marshal. Anyone willing to pay for you? Probably not. Could try to recruit him as a knight, but with only 7 prowess, let's just let him rot in prison for a while. That builds character. Alright, meanwhile, do you see anything happening in Aquitaine? Not really. This is going okay. Yeah, we're still only fighting him and his 288 men. So can I just casually walk over here so they don't have to pay for ships? Yeah. Alright, cool. Let's do that. Can we win this siege already? My wife's pregnant. Again. Slipping away. Ulan seems to be having a difficult time at our latest feast. Sneaked out. Snuck out early and was not seen for an entire rest of the evening. Because you are impatient. Well, sure, if you have better things to do, because I also don't want to make you shy or gluttonous. Also, I don't want the stress. Okay, won the siege here. Which is gonna give me the conquest of Cornwall. No objective held. It's like, I mean, that's kind of just like your opinion, man. I feel like I have the objective. I'm just gonna sit here for a little bit. My cousin was slain in battle. It's very unfortunate for him. Insular exhortation. Has gained a spotless reputation of absolute rejection of any carnal pleasure. His unwavering discipline is such an example. Or further increased by 10, which I probably is very certain it is already maxed out. How commendable. Okay. So now I'm getting war score for this. It's not going to be enough though. I'm fairly certain that I can only gain like 50% from sitting on the war goal. So I'm just want to finish this quickly. He's probably worth war score, but I'm also thinking, yeah, I'm getting 50% from prisoner, but I have 38% from battle, 62% from occupied. That's already 100%. So I can make a little bit of money first, and then end this war. Let's walk over here, and time to invade Aquitaine proper. What about the wife? Unimportant culture. Ah! And people said romance is dead, huh? Anyone else who feels like the Duchess? The wife of him himself. Yeah, sure. Let's ransom her too. Fairly certain now he's kind of a little bit out of money. You know who's not out of money? This guy. Alright. End this war. He's gonna still pay me another 120 ducats because, yeah. That's what you have to pay for this kind of stuff. Nice. Glad we could talk about that one. He's just not joining, right? He's like, no, yeah. Oh, because you're also fighting against someone from down there. My new kid, and she wants to name him after me, and he's quick. I want to say a lovely idea, but we already have one. Like, get some new ideas. Actually, I had something else in mind. Who do we have so far? As children. We've got a Diglo, we've got a Tigalan, got a Wallan. Just the names don't really. Yeah, let's get home with Rook. Don't ring a bell who of my ancestors that was, but sure, let's go with that. My cousin was captured during the siege of Lancaster. There's some sort of, what is this, another peasant revolt? Yeah, not, doesn't Sound like it's gonna be my problem. The White Wolf. As the days pass by and I hear nothing about the White Wolf, I grow restless. Surely someone must have seen it. What about all the peasants littering the hills? Maybe I should appeal for their assistance. Send a missive right away to the peasants. Or I could send my steward. So he's gonna be distracted for 10 years. What's distracted do? Minus one to all stats. It's fine. I'd rather not spend my prestige, I think. Find me that filthy animal. Another cousin slain in battle, another cousin prisoner. My family is growing thinner. Servants and masters. Duke, as daughter, is firmly in my grip. However, with the right strategy, I might raise my upper hand even further. 120 stress, because no. I'm just gonna spread a few rumors about how terrifying I am. It's a weird war. Like, he's not fighting back. What's happening up here? Wales under attack. Cheshire claim on the altar of Lincolnshire. Like a bit of a problem, huh? Okay. But more like a you problem, not a my problem. Yeah, so he's not coming. And I'm just gonna slowly siege down his countryside. And gain some prisoners in the process. Captured Count, what's his face, and four others during the siege. Let's just go there. And he has 1600 men, he's just not interested in doing anything about it. I should probably have a quick look over here. Do I just go for the mass ransom instead of individually going through everybody? I think so, yeah. Dutch as a true populists. Yeah, sure. Ulan has been asking me for a spinning top for a long time, and I told him I would get one for him in 3 months if he displayed more focus on his studies. He responded that he was fine with his current dedication to his studies, reward or no reward. Well, he's currently content. Again, I don't have... Could make him fickle or trusting, which is also bad. Yeah, content is fine. And the Diglach comes of age. Now that's one, he was being educated by my sister, I think. Yeah. sadistic, zealous, paranoid stewardship guy. Well, right, I think we still need to find him a marriage. Again, we could look for someone in Lothringria, East Francia, like all these new kingdoms and empires that are here now. Maybe. Let's see. I mean, that's an interesting choice. Claims on the Kingdom of Galicia, which is not the smallest. I mean, sure, she's 29 and he's 16, but Duchy and Lorraine. Johnson gives us an alliance with Galicia, which is might come in helpful with Alba here. Right, we can also get a second level dynasty here. Now, we do have 2000 points, so we could unlock two first ranks of anything else, or we just focus on one, and I think we're gonna focus here. Chance of reinforcing congenital traits, plus 30%. Also, King Gundbald. Lorraine, the Ranger of Arnsberg. Alright, they are losing wars. Oh yeah, but because we have land here in the Netherlands. That's why we have so many adjacent rulers. Gelre exists, Bar exists. I thought the way Central Europe looked was kind of boring. But these splits recently here, that's, stuff is happening. Today, with the passing of King Diglar, my uncle, the future of Ireland has changed in its course. We will never know if his reign would have united our lands, or if his death is a blessing or curse of his kingdom. So he was the King of Wales. One tale ends and never begins. Died from his internal injuries. Oh, because he was my current heir, that's why I have a special event here. Also, that stress is getting up there again. So who's in charge here? One of my cousins. And the primary heir is my uncle. And they lost this war here. Cheshire. Alright. Anyway. Can we just win this war, please? We're fighting for a single county up here. Like, you should not have to siege down like half the countryside if you're just taking a single piece of land. More prisoners taken, which are not worth anything, so get them out of here. Give me some more money. Oh, I need to nominate someone else. You're right. Could nominate my sister. Interesting. Let's search by rank. Who's currently winning? What are we voting on? Ireland. So whoever I vote for is gonna win, right? Because I have 5 votes. Yeah, let's vote for the guy of Kent. Who is also, well, pretty high up in the election for England. And if I vote here, then he has both rank ones. Okay, so succession is safe. That's the army of Aquitaine. All 10 men of them. Let's see if we can kind of grab them here. I think they're probably away before I'm able to chase them. Legend, following the death sentence of a lowly thief, I asked my daughter Sibylla what she thought. She responded that the sentence was far too harsh for such a small crime. She's just, yeah. That's great. And a new perk. So what do you even want to do? Don't see myself here as a seducer. Oh, my character, rather. I wonder if we torture someone, if that's gonna affect our... if torture is something which I have a problem with because I'm honest and forgiving. I'm gonna go down this tree a little bit. We might just abandon this whole intrigue tree at some point and just focus on, I don't know, learning or diplomacy or something. For now, money, money, money. Are you willing to? Will not accept. You fool. But yeah, this seed should do the trick. Alright, siege 100%, force demands. Disband my armies, alright. Now, I've got this there. Well, first of all, I can probably usurp. Or create the Duchy of Cornwall. And then who's holding this? Some dude. Some Anglo-Saxon dude. It's a patriarch. Family hierarch. Gluttonous and ambitious. Honestly, that doesn't sound like someone. You know what? How about I grant this to my son? My son and champion? Oh, I don't think so. Yeah. You're now the High Chief of Cornwall and also the Earl of Cornwall. Also, law and champion, oh, he can fight. Marshal, sure. My son, please don't. My steward, no. Duke of. He really doesn't like me, huh? Okay. My cousin, a current heir, and a pro score of 1. No, rather not. It's my spy master. You really shouldn't be fighting. Alright. So that was good. It's taking shape here. So, what's happening over here? You are in a war, defending against the Duke of Leon. Something's on fire here. War against the tyranny of King Gashi. Arthur Leon is fighting against... King Garthia. And losing. You have a lot of guys. Yeah, I need 2,000 prestige. We're almost there. The problem is really your alliance with Leon. So here's the question. You're allied to Galicia through the marriage between the King of Galicia and... Okay, so the current queen is the sister of the current King of Alba. But you're ill. Wouldn't that be really bad if something happened to you and your the alliance with Alba would break, huh? So we need to work something out for this alliance to go away. We also need to work something out for our stress to go down. We can do the seclusion thing. Costs me prestige though. I mean, puts us a little bit further away from the 2000. I think though, sorting out the alliance is going to take longer than getting back up to the 2000, so yeah, let's do some stress. That's much better. Anything else urgent? Prisoners can be ransomed. Let's take the mass ransom button one more time. And the white wolf. The powerful white wolf I am hunting comes to me in a dream, judging me with its deep eyes and flaunting its pristine coat of fur. We stand in the hills, everything around us silent, and no matter how I move, I get no closer to my prey. As I claw myself awake, I feel my resolve hardening. It will not elude me much longer. Apparently I've gained a stress level because... I'm over above stress. My spies have informed me about a hunter causing a ruckus in the local tavern. The man has been spending large amounts of gold and bragging loudly about the great deal in stock with a fancy lady in pearls and so. Apparently he drew a map of the local hills on a nobleman. Spies thinks the lady must be scheming against me or one of my subjects. So I already gained 70 stress. I would gain an additional 20 stress from being paranoid, or I could throw him in my dungeon, but because I'm forgiving, that will give me 120 stress. Great. Mental break, because I crossed the stress threshold here. Lately, it feels like I'm constantly being distracted by luscious thoughts and erotic fantasies. With all the hardship of my everyday life, it is all too easy to lose myself in daydreams and forget about reality. The desires are clearly interfering with my life, but what should I do about them? Only in solitude will I find peace. I lose my friendship with Erklärt sie das. Lose 42 Stress, which is not enough to get me below it. And if I'm still stressed in 5 years, I get another mental break. And perhaps a new view of God. I can convert to orthodoxy. Yeah, I think solitude is great. You want someone? Yeah, sure. The other thing is, I'm sitting on all this money. And if I wanna buy more buildings, buildings also cost me prestige, which I kinda need right now. Still wondering if a pilgrimage is able to reduce some stress. I don't think so. It's really just about the piety there, which I'm not too concerned about. Upland conquest of Oversticht. Yeah. Everybody wants to pay me money. That's great. Host feast. That's gonna reduce my stress below the level. Okay, let's do that feast. It's the last thing this episode. Welcome, friends. We got a feast right here. Nobody declined my invitation. That's very nice. Even the Duke of Istanbul really doesn't like me. And I gained some stress. Crowtail. Hi, Queen Uza. Is that too much to drink? Drunken wife, yeah. Even though she insisted on showing us how sober she was, simply rising from her seat proved too much for her, and now I'm covered in stinking vomit. Fantastic. You ought to be ashamed of yourself. Give me 150 stress, because I'm forgiving and an eager reveler. She loses prestige. I could say, hey, what a show you put on, gaining me 20 stress, losing 75 prestige, but at least I gained some opinion of my wife. Yeah, you know what? What an interesting choice to make. I did everything I could ensuring that High Queen Britt and High Queen Lion would be as far away from each other as possible. They are both my wives. Why do I need to keep them apart? They don't like each other? Ladies, there's enough of me to go around for everybody. So who do I want to throw out? So this would potentially create a rivalry between me and Nun, and this would potentially create a friendship and not a rivalry. Easy choice. Guests depart. Prestige, opinion, feast ends. Don't know what's going on. What was it again for? In Ormond, you said. More levies, more control, more prestige. And again, yeah, so it costs 200 prestige. Even though I just spent the other prestige for the stress reduction, that's not something I want to spend prestige on. By the way, which one? So, in every duchy, there is in the duchy capital has a duchy building slot. But I do not have the technology or whatever I need to construct them, so I actually not sure how that's going to affect us further down the road. What's happening here? You are attacking Wales. Yeah, good luck with that. Seems like a smart move. I wanna see this war. Actually, that's almost even. Still gonna lose, but yeah. That's a new way. Okay. Yeah, I think we're gonna put a cut in here. The faction has disbanded. We're still waiting for them. Still allied to Galicia. Probably have to do something about the alliance. I was really considering trying to murder the Queen of Galicia, which I actually have good chances of doing. The stress is the problem. It's gonna bring me over the next stress level again. I don't think there's any quick way other than that to like cancel that alliance. Could also murder the king. The alternative is, again, like he cannot be at war with me and also in a war with me. So I would have to attack someone. Like, I don't know here. Cheshire, call in Galicia and then go around and attack Alba. I don't think Galicia would then be able to defend Alba because they're already fighting alongside me against the big evil Cheshire cat here. That might be an option. That's how I would do it if this was Europa Universalis IV. Like, you get the enemy allies, or if you have common allies, you just declare war, let them fight along your side. And then you declare on the other one, and then they can't defend them because they're already in a war on your side. And you just have to drag out the one war while you finish the other one. That should work. Probably won't. We do have a nice war chest though, so if we need to hire a bunch of mercenaries, which we've never done this campaign so far, and most of them are not available right now, but yeah, you should still have, yeah, 1500 men. You can easily hire like 3000 mercenaries. Right, gonna put a cut in here. Thanks for watching. See you next time.